Hello and welcome to yet another evening of fashion extravaganza at the JW Marriott, Mumbai. Today we experience a timeless collection of Satya Paul's Summer Spring 2003. Hello and welcome to Hello and welcome to yet another evening of fashion extravaganza at the JW Marriott Mumbai. I'm Upasana, your host for the evening. Today we experience a timeless collection of Satya Paul's Spring Summer 2003. We take you back into time, an ageless tribute and legend to the legend of Raja Ravi Verma. Hello and welcome to yet another evening of fashion extravaganza at the JW Marriott. Hello and welcome to yet another evening of fashion extravaganza at the JW Marriott, Mumbai. I'm Upasana, your host for the evening. Today we take you to a timeless collection of Satya Paul's Spring Summer 2003. A legend.
Just give me the catch line for the last one, yeah.
This last phrase I'm repeating, huh? This evening we travel back into time, an ageless tribute and legend to the legend of Raja Ravi Verma. Thank you.
Look at the cam, yeah. No, look at the cam. You're looking from there.
Today we experience and take you back into time to the ageless heritage and legend of the legend Raj Ravi Verma. Today evening we travel back into time, an ageless tribute and heritage to the legend of Raja Ravi Verma. Standing next to me is Mr. Vikram Kirloskar.
Just tell me when to roll, huh?
Standing next to me is Mr. Vikram Kirloskar, Vice Chairman, Toyota. Good evening. Very well, thank you. So what do you think of this event tonight?
Oh, it looks very exciting. All beautiful ladies, beautiful clothes, and our beautiful car here as well.
I was about to say that. What about this beautiful car? Why don't you tell us something about this new car?
We don't manufacture this car. This car is manufactured in Japan. But this is the top end of the line of cars that we sell here. The Camry is manufactured in several countries around the world and one of the largest selling cars in the world. Top-selling car in America for the last several years and the highest luxury car in sales in India as well. We manufacture the Corolla and Qualis. This one is imported.
So how did you get in collaboration with the Satya Paul show and you thought it's going to be a good thing to, you know, publish about your car as well?
Okay, if you look at our sign everywhere, it says touch the perfection. And Satya Paul and Ravi Verma are both perfectionists in their own field. So I think it's a good correlation. That's the reason.
Why don't you tell me something more about your company and your upcoming ventures, something.
We are a fairly young company, I think about 4 or 5 years old. We are situated in Bangalore. We manufacture the Qualis and Corolla from scratch, virtually from scratch. We are basically manufacturing the cars. We have several part companies which supply parts for the car. And we are here in India for the long run. We are looking at being a fairly large player in the Indian market in the years to come. Toyota is probably its third largest in the world in terms of volume, but probably, you know, the kind of in terms of manufacturing, third largest in the world. They manufacture all over the world. Very strong company financially, technology wise, and brand name wise.
So what are your future projects? Tell me something about.
At current, we are concentrating on the Qualis and Corolla as far as the local car manufacturing is concerned. The other project, big project we have is we are manufacturing components for export. So we have a very large transmission project where we'll be happening. From next year, we'll start exporting transmissions to about 7-8 countries around the world, single source. It's about a 360 crore investment.
That's really nice. Thank you, Mr. Kirloskar. Have a nice evening. It was a pleasure being with you.
Thank you very much.
Anything that you would like to tell to our viewers out there?
No, please enjoy the show and please buy a Camry from us.
Thank you so much.
Thanks.
Ladies and gentlemen, standing next to me is the Managing Director for Satyapol, Mr. Sanjay Kapoor. Good evening, Mr. Kapoor. How are you doing?
Good evening. Well, good, thank you.
What do you think about this show, Mr. Kapoor?
It's a very exciting event for us. We at Satyapol have been working on this for about 6 months now. The Maharaja Fateh Singh Museum from Baroda approached us to put together a collection tributing Raja Ravi Varma, the famous artist. And it's been a labor of love for us. We have basically join hands with the famous artist, and we are tributing his old sensibilities with modern clothes. The idea has not really been to recreate garments in the pictures, but to create them using lighter fabrics, using the sensibilities of a woman of today.
So do you think it's the Indian and the Western culture to put it together?
Yes and no, actually, because Raja Ravi Varma was one of the first artists who used the European style of painting, that is, with a canvas and oils and stuff like that. What we've done is we've really been inspired by the Indian women, which is our muse. The beautiful Indian women, absolutely. They don't come prettier than that. That's where our inspiration has come from.
So tell me something more about Satyapol as a brand.
Okay. Well, Satyapol as a brand is 18 years old now. I would say we are a corporate design house in which we run a fairly professional setup. We use different inspirations to create our garments. We have a chain of stores throughout the country, Delhi, Bombay, Bangalore, Chennai, Hyderabad, Jayapur, Madurai. We're opening a store in Calcutta next week.
So you plan to go international as well?
Yes, we recently did two fashion shows internationally in the last 2 months, one in Dubai and one in Tashkent.
So how can you compare the international fashion scene and the Indian fashion scene?
They're both different. The Indian fashion scene is lots of fun because I think Indian fashion has just woken up. The last 5 years has been an advent of internet, TV, communications, media. People want to feel good. They want to look good. They're very interested in dressing up. So it's been great fun actually dressing the Indian woman.
Tell me something more about the garments. A little more elaborated version of what kind of garments you have, and so that you know the people out there would know.
The garments that we're showing today are primarily saris because that's what Raja Ravi Varma is all about. We're doing a lot of outfits with borders, lots of old Indian work like mokash, embroidery, light embroidery, I'd say. The change that we have done with the older garments, we use a lot of lighter fabrics. Today's woman can't wear a 10 kilo sari and walk around. Yeah, it has to look ornate, but it doesn't have to be so heavy. So we use lots of fabrics like brocades, chiffons, georgettes, crepe de chines, jacquards, and old Indian techniques to put together this range.
Say one thing, is there a competition as well? Because there are so many other brands coming up in the market. What can you say about that?
I'm not so sure I'd like to comment on that. I think there's lots of space out there in the field.
Thank you, Mr. Kapoor. It was a pleasure having a word with you.
Likewise. Enjoy the show this evening.
Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, standing next to me is Mrs. Gitanjali Kirloskar, the brand ambassador for Satyapol tonight. Good evening, ma'am. How are you doing?
Very well, thank you.
So what do you think about this event tonight?
I think it will be a wonderful experience because it brings together the finest of very traditional art in the form of Raja Ravi Varma, who's a master of our century as such, and contemporary merchandise in the form of Satyapol Saris, sponsored by Toyota.
Tell me, how have you inspired Satyapol?
I think somewhere they believed that I represent certain traditional values as a member of the Kirloskar family, one of India's largest and oldest business families. And at the same time, I'm also an advertising professional in my own right, pursuing an independent career. So they believed that I, in some manner, integrated traditional values with contemporary living. And I guess that's what the art, the merchandise concept is about. And they saw in that a certain fit.
Can you tell me something about the garments that are going to be on display tonight?
I think the garments, the saris, have taken on the essence of traditional art, Raja Ravi Verma's paintings, the certain regal, the royalty aspect of those paintings, the colors, the concepts, and they've blended it into saris, and I think it's a beautiful blend. I mean, they really look traditional, but they are on fabrics that are really wearable and absolutely that are very modern. There's an element of...
It's a blend of, I think, Western and Indian culture.
Yes, it's a blend of old Indian culture and practical, contemporary, modern values, and which is what I think makes them so beautiful and so appealing. Because you either have the very traditional merchandise in the shops, which is very heavy to wear in terms of fabric and the kind of work there is, or then you have something very modern and graphic. This attempts to bring it together.
Are you wearing a Satyapal sari yourself?
Yes, in fact, it has been created specially for me this evening. And the blouse is a specially woven fabric with two or three different weaves in it. Very unusual, very traditional. Sari is a little more contemporary.
Tell me something more about yourself, and how does it feel to be the brand ambassador for Satyapal, which is a very well-known name worldwide?
I am very, very proud. And I'm even more proud because of the particular aspect of the merchandise that they chose me for, which is traditional and modern. Well, I'm an advertising professional for over 16 years. I'm married into a Kirloskar family, but I've, in some manner, I think, succeeded in carving an individual niche for myself professionally. And while I've run an ad agency for the Interpublic Group worldwide as president for several years, I have now set up a division for the Lo Group, which was earlier Linta's, called Lintertainment, which is India's first professional entertainment and film marketing company in the country. And I think that's very challenging. We've taken on 2-3 movies. We're doing that. We're marketing and promoting them. Additionally, I'm also an actor. I mean, I have just completed a film acting in a murder mystery with Sushmita Sen. And I also write regularly.
I think you're a merge of everything. A lot of things. Why don't you tell me something? You're very interesting. Tell me something more about yourself.
I'm also writing. I love writing. I'm doing a column for Femina, an interview series, where I interview top ranking women CEOs and try to bring out aspects of them that would be interesting to the woman reader as such. Additionally, I'm also very fond of Urdu poetry. And I love
I
travel.
So
and I'm an art collector myself. So that's fun.
Like a perfect evening for you.
Oh, it's been a great evening. And let me not forget, I'm the mother of a teenage daughter who's a wonderful painter, and she's just had her first exhibition.
I think it's absolutely amazing. It's been a pleasure meeting you, Mrs. Kirloskar. Thank you so much.
It's been great talking to you guys.
Anything that you would like to say to our viewers out there?
Yes, I think you should get up every day of your life to win. I think you should look smashing every moment of your life. You owe it to yourself. And I also think that you should live every moment as if it were your last.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you. Can you just say I'm Mrs. Gitanjali Kirloskar and you're watching me on Fashion and Style?
Fashion
and? And Style.
And Style, right. Just 1 second. This is Gitanjali Kirloskar and you are watching me on Fashion and Style. Hello, everyone.
Huh? Vikas's father, he wants to meet me? Go ahead.
Oh, you don't want to stand next to the camera.
Sorry? That's all right, no problem.
Huh?
No problem.
Oh, you're beginning your link.
Next to me is Mr. Corey Walia, who needs no introduction. Good evening, Mr. Walia. How are you doing?
Fine, thank you, dear.
So what do you think of this event tonight?
Well, personally, I'm a big fan of Raja Ravi Verma. The car is sleek. And between the classic painting style of Raja Ravi Verma and the sleek modernity of the car, I've had to arrive at a look that kind of, for the girls, yes, for the girls, which bridges the gap between, you know, the two things, between the high-tech car and the classically fabulous paintings, the beautiful saris. The saris, of course, are the focal point for me to work out of because... But I've tried to give elements of everything. On the eyes, I've used a bit of a silver that's an inspiration from the color of the car. With their hairstyles, I've tried to do parts of the hair is classical and part of it is modern. And with the makeup, again, I've tried to keep it very classical and then a high-tech touch, I've added some colored glitter. Yeah, to go with, you know, basically to pick up on the tones of the jewelry
it's
and the jewelry.
Blend of both.
Sarees. So it's very much, rather than between East and West, between then and now, you know, I've tried to arrive at a synthesis.
So tell me, how did you get started as a makeup artist?
Oh my God. I was a makeup artist before I was a makeup artist because...
okay, you need to elaborate on that.
I always loved doing makeup. And it was my hobby. And even as an amateur, I have gone backstage for my friend Sharmila Khanna, who's choreographed today's show. We are friends for many years. Besides, we are even related distantly, but that's everyone in India is related. So I used to just go backstage, and they used to have a lot of fashion shows in discotheques. And I used to just go backstage sometimes and just carry some of my makeup and, you know, for Rukshana.
The worst in for them.
Rukshana, Todiwala, Sharmila, all the models, Ben, Anna Bredmeier, for all of them, you know, go and do their makeup. And that was like my hobby. And then one day I got fed up of the family business of selling liquor, so I decided that I'm going to change my profession, and I got into this. But what prompted me to get into this was that friends told me, they said, you have a talent, why don't you make a commercial use of it? So I think I made my entry at the right time. There was a space for me. And I had, in between, while on holiday, just done two short courses in makeup. So that's the basic formal
training. That was a bit of formal training.
Yeah, that's the bit. Mostly I've learned on the job. Mostly I've learned by making mistakes.
I think everybody does that.
Yeah. And, you know, it's something where today my hobby I've turned into something that's my profession. It pays my bills. And simultaneously, it keeps me creatively fulfilled. It keeps me happy. And I love my work. I really love my
That's very important. Why don't you tell me, what are the basic things in a makeup kit, in your makeup kit to be precise?
Well, in my makeup kit, actually, my makeup kit is huge. It's very big. And this is just one part of it. Then there are several other bits that are already packed up. But there is a whole lot of stuff that is extra. But I think what's very basic to makeup and that all women should have at all times in their handbags, one is a compact, a mascara.
All the pretty women over there can listen to.
Or a lip balm, a lip pencil, and a kajal pencil. With these five things, you can get an instantly glamorous look.
How about a lip gloss? I think that's the same thing.
Lip gloss, I said. Lip gloss or a lip balm. But, you know, if you have your lip pencil and a lip balm, then it's as good as having a lip gloss. But lip gloss, of course. And I think with these essentials, you can instantly glamorize yourself. You can change your day look into a night look. You know, there's a lot that you can do with just these basics. So I find mascara to be the most important component in makeup. And Indian women, despite the fact that they have the most beautiful eyes in the world, beautiful lashes, they still tend to not use mascara. Mostly it's because they don't know how to remove it. So they get frightened of it.
Why should some viewers how to go about doing that?
Well, removing mascara, use the same direction that you use to put it on. You remove it the same way. So you remove it the same way. You have a cotton with some little baby oil or Vaseline on it. These are the two best ways to remove stubborn mascara. Don't hold your lashes and rub them. They'll come off. It's better to just keep, wipe it upwards, yes. And blink onto the cotton. And that'll save you a hell of a lot of heartache and bother. And mascara is really important. The eyelash curler and the mascara. Yes. Because without the eyelash curler, some people who have long but straight lashes, their eyes...
But a lot of women don't know how to use the eyelash curler. You know, I think that's very important.
I would love to educate everybody on how to use the eyelash curler because it makes a lot of difference.
So, Larry, what is your look for this season? What would you emphasize on?
Okay. This season, pink is still very hot. But I'm emphasizing more on... I'm in India. My context is Indian designers, Indian fashion shows, Indian models. I like to work with eyes. So
it's one of the most interesting features in anybody's face.
Well, you know, I'm called the eye specialist.
I've heard about that.
But I would like to work with eyes. And I also like to work with... I like shading. I like sculpting a face or bringing out the natural sculpture of a face. That's what I like to do, using light and shade to bring it out. We're working with hair. You know, there's so many beautiful hair products. So we're working with hair and trying to bring about the most natural glamour that's possible without it looking too set. Most natural glamour. Of course, I've got some very structured looks here. Mm-hmm. Very, very structured. But some of them are quite free-form. So I've deliberately created that contrast in the looks.
To give that kind of a look.
To bring about the fact that somewhere there's a great formality to Raja Ravi Verma's paintings, The Camry has very classical lines.
So you've merged everything together and given one kind of look.
It has to. It's been very tough because at one stage I was kind of losing it. But I think we've got it quite well.
So tell me another thing, that what do you think makeup is, you know, for the people who are coming up in this field? Can they look onto it as a career option?
Well, yes. It's definitely a career option. It has been. At the moment, there's a little downturn in the industry. There's a little, the entertainment and fashion industry is going through a little economic low. So is advertising. Now, these are the three areas where we
require
film and entertainment, advertising and fashion. And all three are going through a little financial slump. So it's a bit of a regret. So it's a bit down. But otherwise, yes. And I'm happy to say I'm one of the pioneers in opening up the industry to young people, teaching my craft to people and bringing them like into the fold of makeup artists. I think that there's room for everybody, and I'd like to expand my my teaching abilities to you know, other cities and towns, Indore, Bhopal, Hyderabad.
Small cities where it's not very well known.
Where they could do with a dose of common sense yet glamorous makeup, you know, and that's what I believe I specialize in. It's a mixture of common sense and glamour. Common sense for it to survive the climate, and makeup is about glamour. I believe makeup is about glamour.
Definitely. Tell me, what's your favorite cosmetic product?
Kajal.
I think it just livens up your eyes and everything. It just brightens
it
up. And really?
Not right now. I haven't. But I do, and I can. It looks good.
So can you just say something to our viewers out there? A few makeup tips, the basic.
For your viewers, I'd say, one, take care of your skin, drink lots of water, and remember the mascara. Mascara, kajal, lip gloss. These are your friends.
Thank you, Mr. Walia. It was a pleasure having you on our show.
Mr. Walia. Corey. Thank you, dear.
Can you just say that I am Corey Walia and you're watching me on Fashion and Style?
Yeah. Yep. Ready?
Yes, sir.
I'm Corey Walia and you're watching Fashion and Style.
Standing next to me is the choreographer for the evening, Sharmila Khanna. Good evening, ma'am. How are you doing?
Good evening. I'm doing great.
I know, absolutely.
Yeah. But it's a bit, the last minute, we're just about to begin the show, so I'm a little stressed out, but it's going good.
What do you think about this event tonight?
I think it's fabulous. I think you have to hear the music. It's beautiful. It's fusion. It's different. The clothes are amazing. The art is absolutely fabulous. Everybody knows that. Raja Ravi Verma's art. We're doing the art according to, the sarees have been done according to the art, so it's a great year.
I think it's a blend of everything, but the car, the art, everything, the makeup and everything. So ma'am, what do you think, how important is the role of a choreographer in any show?
Very important. For the person who's doing the event, they should know exactly the theme that goes, the crowd, what kind of music they like, the kind of clothes that sell in Bombay. It should have really good food, really good drinks, it should be a really fun evening and people should enjoy it.
So does choosing of models play a very vital role in any kind of fashion show?
Yeah, models play the most important role. The way they look, the way they carry the clothes, the way they have the event. People come to see the glamour, so it's basically connected with the look.
Now, what can you say about the international and the Indian choreography scene? Is it at par?
Totally different, no. Our audience is completely different, so we can't cater to that. Our audience, they like a certain amount of glamour, they like a certain amount. They don't come to buy the clothes off the stage. That's a totally different show, that's a trade show. So it's completely different.
Thank you so much, ma'am. It was a pleasure having you.
Vikram Kirloskar to share his thoughts with us.
Hello. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Just a short speech. I don't want to keep you waiting for this lovely show that's going to come. pleased to welcome you here this evening. For Toyota Kirloska Motor, this is a very young company. It's the first time we are trying to promote culture and art in India. The reason we are associated with Satya Paul is if you look around the place, you'll see our philosophy saying touch the perfection. We believe our Camry is a perfect car, and we believe Satya Paul and Vijay and Raja Ravi Verma are also perfectionists in their own fields. The Camry has been a very successful car in India. We've got a very nice niche for ourselves in the luxury car segment, and it's the largest selling car in the US for the last several years. We produce about 800,000 Camrys a year. I hope you enjoy the show. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Kirloskar. I would now like to... And it is now my privilege to invite on stage His Highness Maharaja Ranjit Singh Gaikwad and Her Highness Maharani Shubhangini Rajai Gaikwad of the Royal Family of Baroda. May I request Mr. Vikram Kirloskar to kindly felicitate Maharaja Ranjit Singh Gaikwad. And may I request Mr. K.K. Swami and Mr. Satoshi Aoki to felicitate Maharani Shubhangini Rajai Gaikwad. Incidentally, ladies and gentlemen, to take the association with Toyota even further, Satya Paul have also designed a range of apparel for Toyota that reflect the Toyota sensibilities. Some of the apparel is sported by our Toyota girls. May I now request Maharaja Ranjit Singh Gaikwad to say a few words.
Namaskar. At last it has happened. It was bound to happen. Maybe not today, maybe 10 years earlier. At last, a house of fashion has been inspired by the works of Raja Ravi Verma, whom, as you know, we had the pleasure of introducing for the first time people of Bombay, and it was well received. Unfortunately, the collection could not be brought to any place or take to any place because there wasn't a proper place to exhibit them. We were very happy when NGMA got the paintings over. And today...
Ladies and gentlemen, we would now like to show you a brief audio visual on Toyota Camry, the car that sets new standards in luxury and style. It is a flat. the one and only Sharmila Khanna. Ladies and gentlemen, the Satyapal Show. and gentlemen.
Thank you. Thank you.
welcome the dynamic trio of Satyapol, Sanjay Kapoor, Jyoti Narula, and Puneet Nanda.
Very well, thank you. Very
well. What do you think about the show?
I thought it was really, really nice. I think he actually took the art concept on the ramp and he was really inspired by the colors and the silhouettes, and I think a lot of thought had gone into it, which is fantastic.
Do you think it was different from the rest of the fashion show, the daily stuff that we have?
It was. I think it was very serious. It was very art focused, which is what his main deal about the whole thing was. And I think it worked out really well. And I think Satya and Sharmila together, I think Sharmila particularly, yeah, really did a fabulous job, yeah, because it came across as with a lot of strength, with a lot of passion, and I think that's what it was all about, yeah.
What do you think of Satyapol as a brand?
I think it's fantastic. I love the way he's expanding. I love the way he's actually getting into retail and a lot of breadth, a lot of the Western stuff and the scarves and all he does. I think he's going great guns.
Is it inspiring?
Very, very inspiring. Absolutely. In terms of marketing and everything, I think he's doing a great job.
Thank you, Aki. Thank you so much.
My pleasure. Sorry? Get inspired by art, get inspired by tradition, culture, look back.
Can you just tell them one thing? Just say, I'm Aki Narula and you're watching me on Fashion and Style.
Okay. Hi, I'm Aki Narula and you're watching me on Fashion and Style.
Thanks, Aki. Standing next to me is Miss Dali Standing next to me is Miss Dolly Thakur. Good evening, ma'am. How are you doing?
Very well. Lovely to be here amongst all these beautiful people over here.
So what do you think about this event tonight?
Interesting. I like some of the designs. And a lovely idea to have amalgamated a commercial venture with art.
I think it's a blend of everything. What do you say?
Good idea. And people with creative ideas always come up with something new which the people are wanting. So I think it's a lovely thing to do.
So are you going to pick up any one of the saris from there?
They're not my style. I don't go in for so much glitter and things. I mean, I have a fairly simplistic style.
What you're wearing is absolutely beautiful.
But still, it's much simpler than what you saw on stage. But I love the white ones with the writing. I'd love one of those.
Very good and different concept.
Statement, and I would have liked one of those.
So much, ma'am. It's a pleasure to have you.
I'm Kiran Kiran. You're watching me on
Fashion and Style.
Ready? Hi, Shams. Hi, I'm Kiran Kher, and you're watching me on Fashion and Style.
Ladies and gentlemen, standing next to me is the famous fashion designer, Mr. Umesh Jivnani. Hello, Umesh, how are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Very well, thank you. So what do you think about the show?
I think at a time when most designers and most labels are looking at the West, Satyapol going back to heritage, going back to Raja Ravi Varma, is a very pleasant surprise. For most designers, it's a big achievement, I think, for them, because before this they were associated with another artist. The saris were very rich in fabrics and textures, and I guess their aim, yeah, the work. I think, you know, they use real zari and things like that. I think the aim is to reach the Indian woman, and the saris are very traditional, very wearable, and I think they've done a great job.
Is it very inspiring? Are you inspired in any way?
I do menswear, so I think that, you know, I would probably pick up one.
You have a lot of ethnic thing in menswear as well.
Yeah, yeah. I'm inspired in a sense. Even I look a lot at Indian heritage and handicrafts to do my clothes. So that's the common link, that they're looking at something Indian. They're not looking at the West. But other than that, I think looking at anything from our country, they're looking at the greatest artist, you know. So looking at anything from our country is something I do all the time. So I'm amazed. I like the clothes very much. And if I had the money, I'd pick up one for my mom.
Oh, that's a very nice thought. Tell me one thing. What do you think about the Indian fashion scene and the scene international and abroad? I mean, is it comparable, or do we still need to catch up with them?
You know, we can't compare, because Indian fashion is made for Indian people. The fashion abroad is for the whole world. Even today, you have foreign designers coming to India and picking up influences from us all the time. So I think we are on par with them, sometimes even better than them. We don't do Western clothes, we do Indian clothes. We can do Western clothes, but they can never do Indian clothes.
Umesh, tell us something about your collection.
In fact, I'm just having my launch of my summer collection in the next 5 days. It's a collection again for men. It's got 200 odd pieces. And again, I've used complete Indian embroideries from every state of India, be it Orissa, be it Bengal, be it...
Is it a blend of Western as well as Indian clothing or just Indian?
Western shirts and trousers, Western clothing, but all Indian textures, Indian embroideries, Indian fabrics, yet contemporary. Their sarees were contemporary. You know, the clothes are contemporary. Only we use all Indian textiles, all Indian embroideries, because there's so much in our country. We don't need to use lycra and lace, you know. We can do so much with our own. So I think my collection is all about, you know, looking at the Indian heritage and looking at the Indian man dressing up in clothes that are wearable, yet trendy, yet Indian.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot, Umesh. It was a pleasure having you here.
Can you just say I'm Umesh and you're watching me on Fashion and Style?
Look at the camera.
Yeah, right into the lens.
Hi, I'm Umesh Ivnani and you're watching me at Fashion and Style. Enjoy.
I have to.
Ladies and gentlemen, standing next to me is the famous photographer who needs no introduction, Mr. Ashok Salian. Good evening, sir. How are you doing?
Good evening. I'm fine. Thank you.
So what do you think about this event tonight?
I mean, it's a friend's show, Puneet Paul, so I can't say it's not good, but I think it's really good.
What do you think about the collection of saris as well as the pictures over here, the paintings?
Well, I thought some of the saris were stunning. I mean, I've not seen such beautiful saris in a long time. I don't know. I mean, I've seen a lot of Raja Ravi Varma's paintings at the National Gallery of Modern Art. They may not come really close to that, but I thought it was a great attempt. Saris. I just pick up some of them and wear them myself.
Only if you could do that. Okay, now coming to a different view, your profession, what do you think about the paintings?
Yeah. I think the great paintings, I think what Raja Ravi Varma tried to do was basically, captured photographs, photographs.
I mean, your profession in painting is very similar.
Since there was no photography happening at that point, I thought he was into like really stick stuff and, you know, real detail, which I don't think is on today. There's a certain charm, certain light in his work, which is fabulous. I mean, I loved it. Modern painting is completely different, but he was a brilliant painter. I mean, you see it. I think a whole lot of photographs eventually were inspired by his paintings.
Tell me something about your work now.
My work?
I can't let you go on that one.
Well, I don't know. I mean, I think a lot of my early work coincidentally was very Raja Ravi Varma. I mean, the kind of lighting that he used. I mean, that he painted was the kind of lighting that I used early on. Today I've changed a lot. I mean, it's more modern and stuff. But my early pictures were a lot like
Raja Ravi Varma.
Yeah, like his pictures.
Okay, thank you so much. I'm not going to take any more time. Thank you so much. And have a nice
bye.
Time.
Yeah, you too. Bye.
Can you just say your name and say you're watching me on Fashion and Style?
Hi, I'm Ashok Salian and you're watching me on
Fashion and Style.
Fashion and Style.
Can you just do that once again?
Fashion and Style.
And Style.
Okay.
Just once again.
Hello, you're watching Ashok Salian and on Fashion... What the fuck? I mean, I'm sorry, again.
What?
See, I can be a good actor. What? Yeah,
just
tell me.
Your name and you're watching me on Fashion and Style.
Okay, my name's Ashok Salian and you're watching me on Fashion and Style.
Thank you so much. Have a nice evening. This is an upcoming channel called Fashion and Style. It's about fashion and lifestyle.
Where is this?
And who's
the main person involved
in this? No, we are Fashion and Style. It is a new thing. It's called Network. It's being sponsored.
Because I really follow Fashion and Style.
Sorry.
Not only in India,
Next to me is Queenie Dodi. Good evening, ma'am. How are you doing?
Fine, thanks.
So what do you think about this show?
Well, it was an unusual show. It was not something that you see all the time because the kind of fashions and the kind of saris that we see in Bombay, it's absolutely different, very conservative, very traditional.
I think it was a mix of everything. What do you say? The kind of work, the kind of colors that they used?
I think it was more work that one hasn't seen in a long time, like Ari work and all that. I don't think many of the contemporary designers use that kind of embroidery. So it was quite interesting. It was like going back,
reliving
times in times, you know, because one... And I don't know how the Bombay audience reacts to this.
Very positive response so far.
Yeah. And some of them were very beautiful traditional saris. And it was interesting to watch it.
And what do you think about the paintings and this beautiful car standing right behind you?
Well, I haven't really you mean what, the car? What is
tell me about the paintings. Have you seen the paintings around? Should I just say anything about the paintings?
Yeah. I, you know, the paintings are really inspirational. And that's how this whole show has come together.
I think they're very lively. What do you say?
Absolutely. Very lively and... I think it was a great idea to incorporate this art with the saris.
Yeah. Are you yourself going to pick up one?
Well, actually, I'm in the process of picking up one because I've got an important engagement next week. So I'm going to melange and seeing what there is for me.
Thank you so much, ma'am. It's a pleasure having you.
And good luck.
Thank you so much. Ma'am, can you just say I'm Queenie Dodi and you're watching me on Fashion and Style?
I'm Queenie Dodi and you're watching me on Fashion and Style.
Me, I have the beautiful Shweta Shetty. Good evening, ma'am. How are you doing?
Good evening. A little tired, but I'm fine.
So what do you think about this show tonight?
I thought the band was amazing. I thought this classical, just to hear the flute and the guy's voice was amazing. I think it's a great concept, live music and Indian music, Indian classical music with this fashion show. It was magical.
What do you think about the saris and the paintings that are on display?
Well, paintings, to be honest, I didn't see, because between the band and the saris, I just thought that was a backdrop. Later, I found out it was a painting because we walked in late. But the saris, what I thought was minimalistic, but very stark, lovely colors, bright, and it came out really, really well.
So are you yourself going to pick a one for you?
I think the one with the peace thing. I'm very into this world peace right now. In fact, I wanted...
This green.
I thought that was a great thing. I mean, if I had to wear this in Germany with this thing, they'd probably go mad. No, really.
Absolutely.
They'd really go mad. I thought that was a nice, something like that I would pick up.
So you basically had a very nice evening here?
I had a lovely evening, especially with the music that blew my mind away. It was perfect.
Yeah. Thank you so much, man. It's a pleasure having you.
Can you just say I'm Shweta Shetty and you're watching me on Fashion and Style?
Yeah. Hi, this is Shweta Shetty and you're watching me on Fashion and Style.
Ma'am, how are you doing?
I'm doing good. How are you?
Very well, thank you. So what do you think about the show tonight?
I think it was a great show. It was lots of fun working with Sharmila. As usual, it's always something that we dream to do, you know, every show to be Sharmila's. Yeah, it's too much fun and very relaxed.
So was it different from the rest of the fashion shows? I mean, carrying off the saris and everything?
No, I think I've done too much of saris and all that. But this one was very particular about the way it has... No, it's not about the way we carried out. Obviously, that is also part of it. But the messages that was behind the show. Basically, with all the thing that's, all the wars that has been happening in Iraq and all that. And the messages that has been written, if you've seen.
That was beautiful, the last part of this.
Beautiful. And especially the message was that Om. And I think I was very lucky because I was wearing that last.
It was very eternal. What do you say?
Yeah, it's something which... which is not earthly at all. It's something which is very spiritual and I really like that part.
So would you actually pick up one of the sari?
I would love to pick up that the last one I wore. I would love to pick up. Because the color combination was also just perfect with that light green and pink and all that. And I think they've done a great job.
Thank you so much. It's a pleasure having you here. Welcome.
Thank you.
watching me on Fashion and Style.
Fashion and Style. Hi, this is Viveka. You're watching me on Fashion and Style.
Standing next to me is the beautiful Achla Sachdev, who needs no introduction. Hi, Achla, how are you doing?
I'm doing fine, thank you.
So what do you think about this show tonight?
Well, I think it's really a great concept, and also because I'm really, really fond of Raja Ravi Varma's paintings, and I know pretty much about them because I followed them through.
That's nice. You're one of the first persons I've met who's actually told me that, who's been following the paintings and everything. How does it feel? I mean, that's a different art altogether.
Well, I think art and fashion basically go together, and considering it's been such a great marriage, and also Satya Paul, who really knows about saris, has interpreted them very well. The texture of the saris is what really comes across in every one of Raja Ravi Varma's paintings, and I think they managed to do that in the show today, so for me that was really good.
So would you actually pick up one of those?
I want to, so I'm going to go to Kimaya and check them out for sure.
Okay, now coming to your thing, what do you think about the choreography of the show? I think it was absolutely beautiful. Would you like to say something about it?
Sorry?
About the choreography?
Yeah, see, a kind of show like that doesn't really require a lot of choreography. You need to be more straightforward and all. What I really liked about the show was, of course, besides the saris, is the music. It was a very good idea to use the right kind of music that blended, and also with the taal and, you know, with the saz and everything, which worked very well with the Indian traditional theme. So I guess, yeah, the contemporary thing was the women with the hair open.
Absolutely.
And stuff. So it wasn't like tied back and all that, but
it is a very today's look.
It's very today's look, yes.
With the traditional
blend and everything.
Absolutely. Tell me, how important is the role of a choreographer in any show?
Well, I think it's very important because, you know, we select the style and how we put it together. We also know, it's like a casting, who's going to look good in what sari, what color looks good on the person, what kind of stage, what kind of music, and, you know, putting it all together. So without a choreographer, you can't really put that together.
I mean, does choosing a models play a very vital role in any fashion show?
Sorry?
To choose the models. Yeah. Does it play a very vital role in any fashion show?
Well, at least me as a choreographer always almost do it like a casting, because I think a model can be very well known and everything, but she might not fit the role. So it's very important to fit them to the look and to the style and to the sari and to whatever it's demanding.
Absolutely.
Suppose there was a jeans kind of look. So the girls who only are used to straight walk and not used to fun and projecting fun, I would not use them in the show. So that's how casting, yeah, so you have to like almost cast them, you know, so.
Thanks a lot for being on our show. Anything for our viewers out there?
Well, always stay in fashion and always stay in style.
Thank you. Can you just say how much less today when you're watching me in fashion and style?
Fashion and style or in style? Fashion
and style.
Okay. Hi, I'm Achla Sachdev and you're watching Fashion and Style. Keep watching.
Thanks, Achla. Thanks. Hi, I hope you enjoyed and were absolutely astonished at the masterpieces of the art by the legend of the past and Satya Paul, a legend today. I'm Upasana, signing off. See you again soon.
One second.
So hope you enjoyed and were absolutely astonished by the masterpieces of art from the legend of the past and Satya Paul, a legend today. I'm Upasana, signing off. See you again soon.